For today's video, let's break down a popular type of therapeutic known as GLP-1 antagonists. But before we talk about the drug itself, what even are GLP-1s? Now, that stands for glucagon-like peptide 1, which is a hormone that fluctuates throughout the day. For example, when the stomach is empty, there's going to be a decreased amount of GLP-1 being released. But when the stomach is full, there's going to be an increased amount of GLP-1 that is released. And that's going to have two main effects on the body. The first is going to happen in the pancreas, where an increase in GLP-1 is going to stimulate an increase in insulin secretion. And that's going to cause a decrease in our blood glucose levels. Additionally, it's going to have an effect in the brain, where an increase in GLP-1 is going to stimulate a decrease in satiety. So someone's going to know that they feel full and they don't want to eat as much. Now, when we think about this in terms of a therapeutic, GLP-1 antagonists mimic this protein. So they can bind to GLP-1 receptors. Those might be present on the pancreas, on the brain, or in other parts of the body. And that's going to have two main effects as well. Now, when we think about this on the pancreas, using GLP-1 antagonists are also going to stimulate that increase in insulin secretion. So we're going to see that decrease in blood glucose levels, and that's going to be helpful for individuals who want to manage their diabetes. When we have those GLP-1 antagonists present in the brain, they're going to also bind to the receptors and decrease satiety. So that's going to help individuals who want to manage their weight. So if you want to know more information about metabolism, I encourage you to check out the free webinar in this video description below.